I open it up for Q&A. I request all of you to be available till the end of the day. After lunch, we have only 3 more presentations, so please have a good lunch and then be with us till the end of the session. It will make the speakers who are going to speak to be very happy, because they put a lot of efforts for coming here first and making the presentation. And now I open it for Q&A. And of course, I have to restrict the time. Maybe I'll take few questions and try to close it in about 10 minutes. Anyone? Please tell your name and to whom the question is addressed.
Yeah, I'm Shankar. Addressed to the Siemens person. How do you integrate the CFR 21 Part 11 standard?
Yeah.
It's something called the CFR 21 Part 11.
Yeah, so there are two parts of it. One is project and another is product. So one is that product needs to be compliant with Part 11. So all the electronic record and electronic signatures, which are the two main pillars of Part 11, they need to be imbibed within the product. So the first is product is compliant with Part 11. Second is project implementation methodology. So we follow GAMP, and there is an internal, process of project management for pharmaceuticals within Siemens, which is based on GAMP 5. So we follow GAMP 5. Just to tell you shortly, is to implement pharma projects. So this guarantees that even the project complies to a standard of Part 11.
I am Ramalingam. I am a DFM consultant. I have a question to Yaviba. I heard through web that in Africa they are adopting DFM in construction industry. Are you aware of it? If there is anything in construction industry, I can also help. I am one of the few pioneers in DFM in India. My mentor is Dr. Anderson. I have now come out with a first book on DFM from India. The book is here. I also displayed here. If there is anything, we can always interact. I can work with you to bring DFM into construction industry. You are telling some pains. I cannot give medicine for the pains. I am in the preventive medicine side. I can prevent pains happening by adopting DFM into construction industry. Thank you. What is your opinion?
I guess we do that one-on-one during the lunch break. Okay, then we have a detailed discussion about that.
I'm Sarangapani from NTPC. My question is to Mr. Rainer of Ariba. This package you told IP, is it a scope of integration with SAP? And there's another question is that in power industry, any EPC contractor has used this package in any case study is there?
No, we are not. Right now, let me think. Now we are talking. We are talking to one prospect now in France regarding power industry, but so far it's mainly oil and gas. The other question about SAP. Yes, we have made some integrations to SAP, mainly regarding materials management. So we have two cases in Brazil where we have integrated that solution with SAP materials.
I am Chandravel from Rosal, Texas. We are focusing into aerospace. My question is to Mr. Ashok. First, I wish to congratulate ADA for successful launch of Tejas aircraft. I understand that you will be getting a lot of production orders for Tejas aircraft from Indian Air Force. How you are going to plan for the wire harness area, which is going to be a huge challenging task? Are you planning any automation in that area?
Okay, now, thank you for your question. Yes, we are faced with huge challenge, and certification in the aircraft industry is a time-consuming affair, and some automation is being planned. There is no doubt about it. But then there are some serious limitations to it, because essentially it is a combination of batch and your process type of industry. That's how it is. Okay.
My question is to Neelam Singh. Actually, maybe Ram can answer. I was expecting one final slide where you would call out the service providers and show their ratings. So maybe like a magic quadrant or something which Gartner produces. So, I mean, does ARC do such type of analyst reporting, or maybe Ram can take up that?
The short answer is yes, we do supplier selection type studies, and we are in the early phases of planning one for the global service providers. That work is yet to be done. So we base a lot of our research on doing quantitative research first, which is what Neelam has done with her service provider study. And when we did finish the quantitative research, it's much easier for us to do qualitative research that's meaningful and fact-based. And that's the next step that we're planning to work. And the global service providers do carry a range of activities. There are some that are very reactive to customer needs and some that are very proactive. Just this week, as an example of proactive, I had a chance to visit TCS, and they showed me their lab on the Internet of Things, where they are doing advanced research and prototyping of various applications that are a couple of 3 years out. And I was actually quite surprised to see that, and because normally service providers are reactive, you know, they ask the customer what they want and then they deliver. So they have some advanced research going on that's very interesting, and I found that interesting. And you know, we include those kinds of interviews and discussions with global service providers in that kind of supplier selection. So it isn't, it's very comprehensive in nature.
The last two questions, please. Yeah, last two questions. Okay.
I am Uma Prasad from BHEL. And my question is for the TCS person. While you know you have given a very good lecture on IoT, don't you think the ease of you know, using all these you know, handheld devices and the things which are in reach for everybody, the various segments are matching, and they are mixing. Actually, I as a end user may want to go into the next level. So how do you manage these overlap of roles?
No, that's why what I told was like there is no one.
You said that you know, in every segment there is a advantage. That I agree. But don't you think there will be overlap of you know, because of the ease of using the technology? I just
Definitely there will be overlap, as well as the way companies wants to adopt also will change. So some companies will choose that I just want to improve my supplier or my serviceman's life to be easy. That could be one aim. Whereas it can also be taken to the how I am going to offer a different services to my end customer, who is just electricity bill payer from every household. Currently, we are all doing in one way. Can it be completely transformed? It can be. So it brings an opportunity only limited by the imagination of individuals.
My question to Siemens person. Ranbaxy implementation, you said MES. What is the platform you are using? You are using your PLM platform, or what is that? Is it a custom thing you are doing there?
No, it's an independent platform. Okay. It's called XFP. It was previously Elan XFP. So Elan was a company which was acquired by Siemens in 2009. So it's an Elan's platform. It's a Toulouse French company.
Thank you.
The last question. If there is still someone wants to ask a question. Okay, if there are no more questions, I think I would like to thank all the speakers for the excellent presentation they made today. and ensuring that we are still within the time limits to break for lunch. I request all of you to come back after lunch. We want to restart the session at 2 o'clock. The lunch is arranged here, so I think it should be possible for us to restart at 2 o'clock. I thank all of you to be with us till the end of the day. Thank you.